Hello guys, welcome to GeeksforGeeks. In this video, we will learn how to search an element in a linked list. There are two ways to do that, iterative and recursive. In other words, we have to write a C function that searches a given key X in a given singly linked list. This function should return true if X is present in the linked list, otherwise it should return false. For example, if the input linked list is 14, 21, 11, 30, 10 and the key to be searched is 15, then this function should return false as the key to be searched is not present in the linked list. But if the key to be searched is 14, then this function should return true as 14 is present in the linked list. Let us now see how the iterative algorithm works. We have to first initialize a node pointer current to point to the head node of the linked list. Then we will do the following operations until current is not null. If the key value of the current node is equal to the key being searched, the function will return true. Otherwise, we will change the node pointer current to point to the next node. Finally, it will return false. Let us now look at the step-by-step explanation on how this algorithm is working. Consider the sample linked list as shown here. The key to be searched is 11. First, we will initialize a node pointer current to point to the head node. As the key value of the current node is not equal to the given key, we will change the node pointer current to point to the next node, which is the second node. Again, the key value of this node, that is the second node, is not equal to the given key 11. So, we will again change the node pointer current to point to the next node, which is the third node. Now the key value of third node is 11, which is equal to the given key. So the function will return true, as we have found the key 11 in this linked list. Let us now look at the implementation of the iterative function in C programming language. The return type of the function is Boolean, as it returns either true or false. This function takes two arguments, the head node of the linked list and the key to be searched. Then we have initialized a pointer to point to the head node. Then we will check if this pointer is null or not. If it is not null, we will check whether the data of this node is equal to the given key or not. If it is equal to the given key, the function will return true. Otherwise, we will update the pointer to point to the next node. We will repeat these two steps until either current becomes null or the key value of the current node matches X. So, if the execution of the while loop terminates because current has become null, it means that we have traversed the entire list but we have not found the key. So, we will return false. We have covered the iterative solution. Let us now move to the recursive solution. As you can see, the recursive function also takes the same arguments as the iterative function, that is, the head node of the list and the key to be searched. Then it checks whether the supplied node is null or not. If it is null, then it means that either the list is empty or we have reached the end of the linked list, so the function returns false. Otherwise, if the supplied node is not null, it checks whether the key of the supplied node is equal to the given key x or not. If it is equal, the function returns true. Otherwise, the function recursively calls itself to check whether the element is present in rest of the linked list or not, and returns accordingly. Let us now try to understand how this algorithm works, one step at a time. Consider the sample linked list as shown here. The key to be searched is 11. As you can see, the head node of the linked list is not null, and the key value of the head node is not equal to the given key. So the function looks for the element in the remaining part of the list. To do this, it makes a call to itself with the second node as an argument. The value returned by this call will say whether the key is present in the rest of the linked list or not. Now the control is in the function where the node is pointing to the second node. Again, this node is not null, and the key value of this node is not equal to the given key. So the function will again call itself with the third node as an argument and search for the element in rest part of the list. Now the control is in the function where the node is pointing to third node. Again, the third node is not null, but the key value of this node matches the given key 11. So, this function will return true. Consequently, the calling function will also return true. This diagram explains all the recursive calls made in our example. First, the function search is invoked by passing the head node and the key to be searched as arguments. But the key value of this node is not equal to the given key. So the function is invoked again by passing second node and the key as arguments. Again, the key value of second node is not equal to the given key. So the function is again invoked by passing third node and the key as arguments. But the key value of the third node matches the key. So this function will return true to the calling function. The calling function will in turn return true from the function which it was invoked. Finally, the initial call to the search function will return true, which indicates that the element has been found. Let us now look at the implementation of this recursive algorithm in C programming language. This function takes two arguments, the head node of the list and the key to be searched. Then it checks whether this node is null or not. If this node is null, the function will return false. This forms the base case of the recursion. If this node is not null, the function will check whether the key value of this node is equal to the given key or not. If it is equal, then the function will return true. Otherwise, it will search for the key in rest of the linked list. With this, we end our tutorial. Thank you for watching. Please leave us your comments.